Hey everybody, it's your girl Bunny. To all of my returning subscribers, hey, how you doing? And for those of you who are new to the channel, welcome. Kick your feet up, subscribe, hit that notification bell so you don't miss any posts. Oh my goodness, can you believe it? We made it. Greenleaf season 5, episode 1, the long awaited season, the final season that is. Now for those of you who are new to the channel, let me let you know that this is a family friendly channel. Be assured that you never have to run across anything vulgar or inappropriate, something that you recommend to your friends, family, and even co-workers. So take a deep breath and know that this channel is not having it, all right? Now, how I do the fluidity of every series on this channel, I give a recap of the entire episode with photos just in case you don't have the channel or you need a refresher of what you've seen. Then I give my review and discussion questions at the end. No need to try to search around. I put all of the minute marks in the comments. Now, for those of you who need to see season 4 and binge watch, don't worry, I got you. I'll put that link in the comments as well. It's all coming up. Greenleaf season 5, episode 1. I'm not gonna waste any more of your time. The recap's coming up next. Opening scene, Bishop is deep in thought before Grace grabs his hand and guides him out of the main auditorium. And we see that Harmony and Hope has a media outlet that is recapping this demolition of property. And they plan to expand to something bigger and better. The staff is taking away any and everything that has to do with the Greenleaf family and the Calvary Church. And Grace is asking Bishop, like, why are you making me do this? Why are we even coming here? And Bishop says, you know, sometimes you have to see things in. It literally fall down to construction and just demolition. So you're not tempted into thinking that certain things can come back and things can magically be the way that they were. Let's just see this for what it is and just accept that it's over. Lady May, she is declining any food, anything besides some tea, because in her mind, she is fasting and praying for clarity and some type of sign. And as she's doing it, Charity comes downstairs and Lady May addresses her as Benedict Arnold, a traitor to the family, and Charity just tells her whatever as she walks through the door. And as she walks out, Aaron stops by and he says that he wants to speak with Grace. And she expresses that, you know what? I don't even want that church. Maybe that church wasn't meant to be in the first place. And Bishop just walks by, says hello to Aaron, but totally disregards Lady May because he's just over it. Aaron says that he wants to share news with Grace, but feels that AJ should be present as well. Jacob, he asks Carissa, okay, this paperwork that you're showing me, what is this supposed to convince me of? And she says, well, it will convince a courtroom and a jury will convict your father for stealing this house from under this helpless old woman. And Jacob says, you know what? Wow, you passing out chlamydia and wills. What do you want from me? And she says, what I want, since you want a divorce so badly, is that you need to make sure I'm taken care of better than any other woman has seen in Tennessee. And Jacob says, you know what? I'm over it. Just name your terms. Make sure you have the paperwork with the attorneys, and that's it. Miss Sophia, she get a call from her boo while she out taking a nice little jog in a sweat on. And he wants to know, okay, boo, when can I stop by? And Sophia says, well, you can stop by, but it's really not a good idea because Nikki, she's still here at our house. And he's shocked to learn that Nikki is still there, but he agrees to meet up with her later on that evening, maybe when she can work out something with Nikki. Now Charity, she's at the church and she ignores Phil, but he stops in front of her just to calm her down from being so upset, because she wants to remind her that they have to meet with the board and the new staff. And it's her best bet that she seems cordial and that she can control herself in front of everybody. Aaron shares some information with AJ and Grace, and he wants to let them know that the case is closed. But AJ wants to know, well, who's the suspect? And Aaron shows a photo to Grace, and it's a random man. It's the random man she saw while praying, and Grace is taken back. It seems as if she's having an adrenaline rush from the news. And Aaron explains that he died last night during some shootout at a store, and he matches the surveillance footage. So the matter and everything is closed. So they should actually be celebrating.
but Aaron is confused why the tone of the room is down and that AJ seems sad.
Jacob sees Aaron leaving the house and he tells him, hey man, you're just the man I wanted to see. What do you think about that? And it's the same will that Carissa gave to him. Darius with the Tennessee Times, he is inquiring over the phone about a return phone call from Bob Whitmore. And then he sees Grace walk up and he's shocked to see that she's popped up unannounced. But Grace tells him that, hey, I need a favor. And I felt that if I talked to you over the phone, you wouldn't hear me out. And so I just popped up. Darius said, you know, I'm just kind of disappointed that you didn't announce when you were coming. And I hate how everything ended between us. But he agrees to meet up with her to discuss some things over coffee. Jacob tells Aaron, look, I know how this paperwork looks, but it can't be true because there's no proof, right? And Aaron says, well, based on what I heard about Mac, I mean, it's probably true, but it probably won't hold up in court. And I would need some type of documentation that superseded this will to convince me otherwise. And I hope that whoever is trying to use this will against you, man, that there's some sort of peace that comes from it. And Jacob says, well, you know, that's highly unlikely, but I see you, man. So they dab and Aaron heads on his way. And we see Jacob make a call requesting his phone to call Joyce Meyer. But it goes straight to voicemail and we hear that it's for someone named Alexa. So Charity and Big Head, they speak with the board concerning where services will be held until construction is completed. And some of the board members are asking questions. Will there be a wheelchair ramp? Do we know how long this will take? And as he's talking to everybody, you know, Charity, she interrupts and quickly announces that she and Phil will preach during this transition. And the lessons will include how to deal with being forgotten and rejected. And the women should be fired up and ready to hear such a wonderful message. And she goes on and on how she will be the lead and she cannot wait to share these messages. And Phil is just looking like, oh, I can't believe it. And as the meeting comes to a close, he tells her, look, I know what you're trying to do, but Charity says, you know what, I'm only securing my investment and there will be other things that we can discuss. But other board members overhear this and they don't like what they've heard. So Jacob goes to see Miss Alexa, honey. And for those of you who have forgotten, she's the one that he had the affair with a while ago. Remember? Do you remember? So he asked her, hey, you know, I really wanted to talk to you. And she's surprised that, what do you want? Why are you here? And he's even more surprised that she was open to the invitation of him even speaking to her. She says, look, everything that happened in the past was the past, but I am still a Christian and I wanted to hear you out and see what you had to say. As Jacob is listening to her speak, he's looking around the apartment and he sees toys from a child. And with his no neck and flared nostrils, he's thinking, oh man, what's really going on? And you can tell he has some concern because this child is matching the time frame of when they was kicking it. Grace talks to Darius and tells him to look, I need to know some information concerning this young man killed in this shootout. And this is the same person, believe it or not, that I saw one day when I was praying, and it's not adding up. Can you find out some ID information about this person? And Darius says, look, I'll look into it and do what I can and I'll keep you posted. But besides all that, I miss you. And despite everything, I have been missing you and thinking about you. And Grace says, you know, likewise. Charity is in her office and she hears somebody knocking on her door. And she says, look, come back. I'm doing some prayer. And, you know, Charity's friend walks in and says, girl, you're going to have to tell Jesus. Can he hold on a minute? Because I have something really, really important to tell you. Look, I didn't spend my entire career, 25 years to be exact, to sing some Pinkberry gospel in a gym. And is it with H&H? No. And Charity is crying and he sees the tears and he's like, look, we're still going to be social with one another. What's the problem? I mean, Charity, you are finally starting the career that you always wanted. You're AP. So what's the deal? And she tells him, you know, I would quit if I could, but I can't. He tells her, girl, I love you, but I quit. I can't do this. Jacob is still talking to Alexa, and the child appears to be biracial.
And we can connect the past affair with this child possibly. And Jacob says, look, you seem to be doing well. And Alexa says, if you can call it that, I guess so. But what do you want? And Jacob explains that, look, I need to know if you have old documents from Mac. And Alexa says, that's what you came over for? You get me fired. And now you're asking about some documents. You're asking about Mac's stuff. And he's like, look, I just need some old documents because Carissa and I are getting a divorce. And she says, look, I was his secretary. I was his assistant. But I don't have every single piece of documentation that he ever owned. And Jacob finally says what's on his mind, looks at the little girl and asks, is she mine? And Alexa confirms, if it were yours, I would have got rid of it. And you can see the hurt in Jacob's face, but you can kind of tell Alexa said that to hurt him. And as Jacob gets up to walk away, she says, look, Mac kept an old storage unit and I don't have a key. And I didn't want to look because I was always too scared to see what was in it. Jacob apologizes to her after all the mess from years ago and his actions. And he says that I just can't stand how everything ended in the past. And that's not how I wanted things to end. Grace speaks with AJ and says, look, that guy was killed. It's terrible that it happened, but this case is over. You don't have to deal with it anymore. We should be happy. And Grace insists that they spend some time together, her, Sophia, and AJ, just to reflect that he's free. And AJ is still reluctant to go out and agreeing with what she says, but he ends up saying, you know what? Yeah, let's celebrate. Let's have fun. And she says, well, great, good. That's what we'll do. She gives him a hug and she leaves the room. But we can tell from AJ's face that he's very distraught and sad about something. And he packs up his bags to leave, but something is holding him back. Members of the board, they complain and rant to Bishop that they didn't agree to H&H completely tearing down the church. And that if they would have known that everything was going on the way that it did, they wouldn't have voted the way that they did. And Bishop is annoyed. And he says, you know, Connie was just trying to make peace with what was going on. But they say, no, Connie never indicated them starting over. And why did she advise us to vote that way? And I did. And Bishop says, look, let's just pray about it before we even go any further. And they have a prayer together to get their thoughts and collect everything that's been happening. Jacob goes to the storage unit location and he shows the employee the necessary documents to prove that this person is deceased and that he has the right to get it open. And as it opens, he notices that there's boxes and boxes of stuff and paperwork. And the employee explains to him, hey, there was a 2-year contract on this union and it's just about to come up. And Jacob says, hey, just extend the contract for another 6 months. The employee tells him, hey, I need that paperwork back before you leave, but take your time. And Jacob just looks at the unit thinking, man, like what could possibly be in here? Grace gets a call from Darius to tell her some news, but he expresses that, hey, you need to be in person to get this information. I know why H&H is doing what they're doing. I know why they're here. Miss Sophia. But Miss Sophia goes to see her bae, only to find out that Nikki is staying with him now. And she's like, well, what is this? What's going on? Like, why is she here? And he's like, look, she had nowhere else to go. She's staying here. And Sophia is like, okay, so what's going on with us? Are we not together anymore? You know what? You don't have to tell me that. I know that you guys share something that has lasted for years, and I know it's not over between you two, and I know you're just not letting her stay here. And he tells her, look, she's just staying here until she can get on her feet, and you told me to take care of it, so I'm taking care of it. Sophia has had enough and tells him, you know what? Just leave me alone, and you just do what you do. And technically, I'm glad because I'm tired of seeing his face. Bishop talks with Lady May and says, you know what? Moving forward, We just got to see eye to eye on everything. And I know you're fasting, and I know you're trying to clear your mind about everything, but just hear me out. When I saw Calvary's things and all the items just being tossed in the trash, that told me that that chapter is over. We've got to start over. And you showed me that gift that you had when you got back in that pulpit. You had something that I was lacking and that I didn't have anymore. The first step is going down to City Hall and getting married. And then we're going to start our own church. Now, I know you're praying and fasting and looking for a sign, but how's that for a sign? And Lady May is overjoyed at the plan. Charity goes to see Phil as he's packing up all of his memories of her, but she wants to tell him that, look, I want to give you this ring back. And he lets her know to keep it and see it as a memento for their love. And he explains that he loved her and he wanted to move forward, but he wanted to have his own church and to be a preacher of his own church for so many years. And the only catch was that if he married Judy. And Charity says, you made your decision. You let me go off of what you wanted. You're proving to me that clearly this is what you want. So I don't want your ring. Do whatever you need to do. Darius is filling in Grace on all of the new information that he has. And he's like, look, when I wanted to speak with Bob Whitmore, he would always go around the questions I ask him of why he left Phoenix. He never gave a straight answer. And Grace is just like, yeah, whenever we would ask him questions about why he wanted Calvary so badly, he always went around that question as well. And he's like, look, I found out that Bob purchased a home and the neighbors confirmed that it was empty the entire time, and he made several donations to local charities. And the same thing happens when people are trying to find an expiatory committee. And it's evident that he's running for Senate. And as a Republican Senate candidate, a big multiracial church that he'll have that in the back of his pocket. And it's pretty much unbeatable. And Grace says, well, yeah, I mean, it's pretty much unbeatable, but I mean, it's something that you can always have, so I don't see the end result of this. And he's like, well, just have faith that things will work out. And Grace goes, who wants things to not be happy? And who doesn't want harmony? And who doesn't want a multicultural church? And she's like, oh, but excuse me, I got a text message. Apparently, I've been invited to a wedding. So Carissa tells Jacob, look, we're getting dressed to go to your parents' wedding, but I just want you to know to get everything ready. And Jacob says, you know what? Do what you want. Make sure that you have the lawyers that you want. The lawyer that I have is fine. There's no need for a fight. All right. So let's just keep going. Let's just leave. So then we see that the entire family is get ready. They're meeting up. We got Sophia showing up. Everybody's getting dressed. Sophia's going to change into something else. And of course, you know, Zora, she's saying, hey, you know, what do you give, you know, advice to them for their wedding? And they're not saying anything. And Jacob was just like, let it go. Let your mother be upset. It's whatever. And she's just confused why they're acting that way. They're all getting ready. And they're like, well, where's Grace? And they're like, she's on her way. Where's Charity? She's on her way. And Lady May is just like, see, I told you, this should have just been something between you and I. And Bishop says, no, this is a family matter and everybody needs to be here. As Grace gets out of the car, she's like, well, where's AJ? And Sophia comes out and says, well, I didn't see him when I went upstairs. And she's like, well, let me go up there and see where he is. I really want everybody to be there for this special day. Then Charity pulls up and she's just like, wow, you know, everybody's here. But I'm just surprised that you guys wanted me to come. And Bishop grabs her and gives her this hug. And he's just like, girl, get in the car. Grace, she goes upstairs to see where AJ is. She's knocking on the door. There's no answer. She's tugging at the doorknob. There's still no answer. And she hits and hits and hits the door until she walks in and she sees that AJ
is on the ground and there's blood everywhere, and he has slit his wrist. He has attempted to commit suicide, and Grace is crying, wondering, why did you do this? Why did you do this? Things were okay. It was fine. And she is breaking down, and she is in hysterical tears, asking for help and screaming for help as if somebody can help her. And that is the end of the episode. We are to season 5, episode 1. Now, what I said on the final review in the final episode of season 4, that it was my prediction and it was necessary for Greenleaf to have one more final season, a season 5, that it should all come to a close with one more season, not be canceled, not that it deserves to go off, but the fact that it needs to come to a close. And I give all of these reasons of why a lot of the plot lines and writing was starting to super exceed itself, meaning that a lot of the plots were running over and over and over without giving any explanation. But what they did was they added more plots and more issues on top, and they expanded the characters of what we were used to from seasons 1 through 3. Now that can be to a point where people are still watching it, but it turned into soap opera-ish style for the series instead of a drama series of how it began. Let me clarify, very entertaining, love the show. I reiterated over and over again that with the new writers, something had changed. It was something that would always bang, ping pong back and forth about, that we really didn't get clarification on. And if you want to watch that, that is the final episode of Greenleaf season 4, where I give and I list all of these things of why it should come to a close. When that happens, it happens with a lot of shows. Good, perfect example, Walking Dead. It's, instead of it being a good 5 seasons and summarizing everything with the comic books, it kept going and going and going, giving us these unlimited scenarios and plots and just exhausting your audience. And you don't want to do that with a good series. You want to end strong, which brings The Wire and Breaking Bad as, and Game of Thrones, excluding the last season of Game of Thrones, to be my top 3 series of all times. And the reason why that's rated that amongst all people and critics is that because there was consistency and there was fluidity throughout the writing of the series. Now, if you noticed, Greenleaf was supposed to premiere January of 2020. And a lot of people were confused about what was the holdup, what happened? Well, I would just love to think that they saw my recaps and my opinions, because they did some old switcheroos of the writers. And not only that, the cinematographers were swapped out. Wonder why? And it's good to close on a good note and end strong when it comes to clarification of so many plot lines, things that weren't addressed since season 1, the rush job of season 4. Even though it was great, it was rushed, and there was just so much going on with too many people. When you do that, you have to evolve into a soap opera, because it just keeps going and going and going and going. Now, another note about the series, there has been word of a spinoff. And that is why you've already exhausted not only the writers' contracts, the writers and the cinematography going all the way up into season 5, but you've exhausted the possibilities of now this harmony and hope, this new element that was introduced into the series. So it makes sense to have a spinoff so you can take your time with a lot of the characters and a lot of plots and some additional ones. There were so many more additional characters added that were unnecessary. So this talk and this premiere of this spinoff will be excellent. And I can make a good guess that they'll introduce that into the last and final seasons of season 5, giving the audience a sense of closure in some way. And a good example of a series that kind of left you hanging with The Sopranos. You were only left with an idea of, okay, I guess that happened, because they left us with
that information. So I'm hoping with Greenleaf that they end the series with closure, and also, okay, we'll learn about that later in this spinoff. So let me know how you feel about that. Now, many of us predicted that AJ was an AJ. I even said in the last review that what she saw in that final episode of season 4 had to have been a presence of some sort, because there was this person that arrived literally out of thin air that got onto the Greenleaf property going past securities. So that seemed kind of odd. So we predicted that, kudos, that we guessed that that had to have been a presence, you know, something spiritual. AJ was clearly consumed by guilt. It's very evident that he was hired by the Whitmores to pretend as if he were AJ, to keep going with this lie, to get Grace legally bound to some lies in some sort of way. That's what I get from it. That's my prediction. Let me know if that's your prediction as well. But the guilt led him to commit suicide. Now, I do think that Grace will eventually find out that that wasn't her real son, and that her real son was the one that was shot in the robbery of what that happened. And I think that that will bring another side out of her, that she really didn't get to meet the true son that was hers. Or do you think that her real son is still out there? Let me know what you think. I predict, of course, along with everybody else, that what Aaron said was some foreshadowing, and him saying that you would need some documentation that supersedes this will. So it's evident that Jacob will have to go through all of that paperwork to find some sort of information, maybe a superseding document will that was before that one. The question is, why are there two different versions of a will, and what was Mac or somebody else trying to do in that situation? I do think that is a good idea that Bishop has to say, you know what, let this be. Me seeing them throw all of the stuff in the trash from Calvary made me close that chapter in my mind and in my heart. I think that them having a new church will be great, but you got to think, where's the funding gonna come from? Is Grace gonna pay for everything since she got a little stash from, you know, her life? And, you know, is that something that they're gonna do? It's very interesting to see how they're gonna wrap all of this up. I do see that they are fast forwarding and giving us closure very quickly, because we don't know how many episodes. IMDb has not released how many episodes will be in this season. A good guess, maybe 8 to 10 episodes will be left. So if that's the case, they need to wrap a lot of stuff up. I do see that they hurried up and closed off that Nikki situation and just wrote that out real quick, because we can do without those two characters. We can do without the basketball character. We can do without Nikki. She can get up at the house. Where's your family? Call your mama, okay? Call your daddy. but it's just like, you know, the writers are really wrapping it up. And it was interesting to me that Darius confirmed a lot of the things that a lot of characters were thinking about the will. So it's interesting. Lady May's sister, the one that was in the bar all the time, and one that was played by Oprah, I forget her name, but will she know some information about Mac? Because remember, she said the family had a lot of secrets, and she was just done with all the secrets, and she was just trying to move on with her life. So much in season 1 that's kind of catching up with season 5, and the writers are trying to tie all of that together. Who will be the one to help out the Greenleafs? What will be that turning point, do you think, to finally get the truth about the Whitmores out, and that them wanting the church so badly? The information that Darius shared about Bob trying to go for Senate is something pretty big, and the idea about having that black vote behind the church, very powerful, and a lot of foreshadowing and deep debate questions that you could talk about even outside of Greenleaf that have absolutely nothing to do with the show. But I thought that was a great note to put into this series. It happens with the Queen Sugar series and talking about real topics or real issues, and they're bringing it in more than ever in season 5. Let me know what you think. Subscribe and hit that notification bell. I hope that you appreciate all of the editing and all of the hard work that us YouTubers put in. Share the information, share this channel, and you guys, we are ready to rock and roll for season 5. I'll see you next week. In the meantime, check out those playlists. Check out other things on this channel. There are plenty of shows to look at and binge watch. Until next time, I'll see you. Bye.